Hi everyone. In this video, we will review how to read CSV files into a PySpark DataFrame. Before we get started, let us review the packages we will utilize. These include OS, Time, Pandas, Matplotlib, and PySpark. At this point, I will import the packages. Now, let us review what PySpark is. PySpark is a Python API for Apache Spark. PySpark is used for real-time, large-scale data processing in a distributed environment. For CSV files with millions of rows, the size of the file can be well over a few gigabytes. Attempting to open the CSV file with a program such as Excel would cause it to crash, and programming packages such as Pandas could be slow in reading such a large file. Reading the CSV into a PySpark DataFrame could be an optimal solution. Let us get into the code. First, I am going to initiate a Spark session. A Spark session is a class from the PySpark module. It is the entry point to working with Apache Spark. This will allow us to create a PySpark DataFrame where we will read in data from our CSV files. Next, I am going to list all the CSV files we are going to work with, as well as the size of each file in megabytes. One of the datasets we will work with is from Kaggle, which contains data from LinkedIn. To access the dataset, you will need a Kaggle account. The link to the dataset can be found at the bottom of the notebook. We have two CSV files from the dataset we will focus on. The first gives job summaries for a variety of jobs and is about 5 gigabytes, and the second is a list of job skills and is a little over a half a gigabyte in size. The read test directory contains CSVs created synthetically. The files each contain 5 columns with a varying number of rows per file. For those that want to follow the steps in this notebook, I included another Jupyter notebook in GitHub to create the synthetic dataset. Please note, if you do create the files, they total a little over 8 gigabytes in total size. Now that we have an overview of our datasets, let us create a PySpark DataFrame from one of the CSV files. I will call in the Spark session, then I am going to call read, then CSV. I am going to read the job skills file. The file has column names, so we will have to set the header equal to true. The way Apache Spark reads data is with a schema. We will get into this more later in the notebook. For now, I will set the infer schema parameter equal to true. Spark will look at each of the columns in the CSV file, and it will determine the underlying data types for the columns. You might also notice when you run the cell, there are different stages. Because we are inferring the schema, Spark is running an internal calculation, which we will call a job. And this job is broken down into different stages. The more complex a calculation or formula, the more stages there will be for the job. We have our PySpark DataFrame set. We can now take a look at the first 5 rows of the DataFrame by calling the show function. We have just 2 columns, a link to the job and the job skills corresponding to the job. We can take a look at the dimensions of the DataFrame by calling on the columns property to retrieve the number of columns and the count function, which will return the total number of rows for the DataFrame. The job summary CSV has just 2 columns, but almost 1.3 million rows. We can also take a look at the schema of the data that Spark inferred. We can call on the print schema function to do this. We receive an output that describes the data types for both of the columns, which are both string types. There can also be null values within both columns. Now that we have read in our first data frame, we will create a schema to read in our next CSV file into another PySpark data frame. Within Apache Spark, a schema provides the data format for a data frame or a data set. For our schema, we will first set our struct type, which is a set of struct fields. A struct field contains information for a given column, including the column name, the type of data within the rows, and whether or not the row can contain a null value. I am going to name the variable schema, then call on the struct type object. Within a list, I am going to define the struct field for each of the columns. I have to input 3 parameters for each of the struct fields: the column name, the data type, which will be an integer for all the columns, and if the column can contain a null value. I can read one of the CSV files I created synthetically into the second PySpark data frame. Like before, I need to include the path to the CSV, which is in the retest directory. I need to specify the header, and instead of inferring the schema, I am going to explicitly set the schema parameter equal to my schema variable we defined in the cell above. You will notice that when you read in a PySpark data frame with a schema, there will not be any stages because PySpark does not have to run in any internal calculations to figure out what the underlying data types are for the columns. This makes reading a CSV file much faster when the schema is set. We can again take a look at the first five rows of the data frame with the show function. We have our five columns, which contain only integers within the columns. Next, we can print out the dimensions again. In this data frame, we have 3 million rows. You will also notice that the stages come up again. This is because PySpark has to run a calculation to get a count of all of the underlying rows within the data frame. We have seen how we can read in a single CSV file into a PySpark data frame. Now we will learn how to take multiple CSV files and read them into a single PySpark data frame. I am first going to use list comprehension to save all the file names into our CSV underscore files variable. I am also going to get the size of all the files in megabytes using the getSize function from the OS module. Let us print out the total size of all the files. The size of all the files in my synthetic dataset is about 8.2 gigabytes of data. Now we will create our third PySpark data frame. Instead of inputting a single path to the PySpark data frame to read all of the CSV files into a single data frame, I can use the CSV files variable as the path. As a reminder, the variable contains the path to all of the CSV files. I am going to set the schema equal to schema and set the header equal to true. And because we set the schema, there are no internal jobs that PySpark has to run to figure out the underlying data types. And even with a total of 8 gigabytes for all the files, we can see that PySpark is able to quickly read in all the files. And as we did for the previous PySpark data frames, I'm also going to show the first five rows as well as the dimensions. To get the dimensions, the calculation did take some time to run, about a minute or two in total. We can see that the stages are broken down into 67 tasks, which is much more than the previous ones, given the size of the data we are working with. We can see that within our third data frame, there are 204 million rows. In the last section, we will compare PySpark read times to pandas. First, I will read in the job skill CSV, which is about 600 megabytes. We can see that reading the file into a PySpark data frame is faster than pandas by about 5 times. Also note that we are inferring the schema, so it will take longer for PySpark to read it in. Next, let us try to load the job summary CSV. For PySpark, it takes about 10 seconds to read in a CSV that is approximately 5 gigabytes. Let us now try to read the file into a pandas data frame. In this case, the kernel restarts because my system has run out of memory. There are ways to optimize the read with pandas, but the default pandas settings cannot handle such a large file. I am going to reload some of the variables, and then we will head into the last section of the notebook. In the final section, I'm going to run a few code blocks that are going to compare the read times for pandas, PySpark, and a PySpark read with a schema. The 16 files read in vary by size from 56 megabytes all the way up to 1 gigabyte. Let us run the code. We can see for smaller file sizes, pandas and PySpark inferring the schema is about the same in terms of how long it takes to read in the datasets. However, as the file size increases, pandas slowly becomes relatively slower. We can also see when the schema is set, the read time for PySpark is well under a second. The question that you may have is, when should I use PySpark? As always, there are a variety of factors that affect this decision. If you are working with medium to large size datasets, around 1 gigabyte or above, then PySpark may be a more optimal choice relative to a data analysis tool such as pandas. When reading in a CSV file for the first time, you can initially set the infer schema parameter as true to find the data types for each of the columns. After the data types are identified, for the columns, a schema should be created to significantly improve the read times for the CSV file. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. In the references and additional learning section, I included references you can look up if you want to look more into PySpark. If you found the video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. Thanks again, everyone, and happy coding.